Well, hello and welcome again to Edison Light Globe's video. Today I'm going to show you a lamp holder that we haven't seen before. We haven't done an E14 wiring, but it's pretty simple, but we will get to that. Now, we've traditionally had these in Bakelite, 240 volt E14 for small candelabra type bulbs. We have an Italian made steel case brass plate that we use quite a bit. It's quite a good lamp holder. Now, we have actually had, despite the fact that we're now in stage 4 lockdown, because we're online, we're still able to operate. There's 5 of us here at any one time. We've still got deliveries coming in. So everything's going as normal, provided we wear a mask and wear gloves and we're socially distant. That is, we keep 2 meters away from each other, we're able to continue to work. Now, the 2 meters is really handy because that's my height, which apparently, according to my wife, makes me a social distancing tool. I don't know what that means. Anyway, despite that, we did get a brand new E14 lamp holder that came in during the week last week, and this is a solid turned brass lamp holder. It's a fantastic quality lamp holder. I'll show you a close-up soon, but it's made of a solid brass CNC milled two-piece device. It is. Now, we think that this might be really handy where you have to attach a shade to an E14, and I'll explain E14 in a way. It's not common to use E14. E14 is usually for a candelabra, you know, chandelier, a small wall light, that type of thing. And the globes themselves are inherently small because the screw is very small. So they will be quite a small unit in itself. So don't expect bright globes, but a candle type of globe. Now, the really good thing about these is that we can attach, because we have shade rings on these, and these shade rings are exactly the same dimension as the shade rings on a B22 lamp holder, which means it can accept a gallery. I'll put that on a bit further. Sort of regular gallery, but we would put on a gallery like just a 2.25, because it's only going to be a small shade because it's a small lamp holder. So once we get this on, I'll show you. Maybe I won't put it all the way on because it takes a long time to screw it up. But essentially that's the size of the gallery. Now, the gallery would take, again, probably only a small type of shade, and it might only take something like a small glass shade, a small metal shade, but in this case, a little candelabra type unit, and that would be quite okay on a multiple globe chandelier or in a single wall light. I might do it like that, but a single wall light that comes off a bracket, something like that. So these are really handy little lamp holders. Now, before I drop everything, I'm going to show you the other parts. So these, obviously, because they're made the way our regular brass or solid brass components are made, they're available in the bronze, the new brass, the antique brass, and nickel plated brass. So they come in the range that we would normally have all of our brass components in. They also come without the shade rings, so just with a smooth side. Now, this essentially is for a lot of things where you obviously never going to use a shade, and so they're just a bit neater. They don't have all the threads and shade rings on, and again, for little wall lights, that sort of thing, perfect. Now, I've made up a couple here which are basically batten holder adapter type. So we've attached the E14 lamp holder to a wall mount plate, which is, again, a specific one that can fit over a galvanized conduit, like a surface mount fitting. There's a few things this can do. This can go mount straight onto the wall or a ceiling, just for a small globe effect. Again, I'll show you another different one. Again, just a small light. You might have a number of them. in a situation, but oops, there you go. I'll screw that in. So you can imagine these obviously being used on a wall, on a ceiling. Fairly cute. We also have just a sample at the moment, but these all also come with a cord grip top type, which would be used for a pendant. Now, can't really see there being much use for E14s as pendants. That's not common because it defeats the purpose really of having the small fitting. You might as well have E27 if you've got a bare globe pendant or a pendant with a shade. So probably not much use. Okay, so all of the E14 lamp holders we have available by default with a 10mm 26 TPI, I think it is, a 10mm M10, a threaded entry. So we will take an all thread for wiring into a lamp or into a chandelier, that type of thing. You can obviously, because it's 10mm, you can employ a 10mm hook, which means you could hang this up as a pendant and hang this from chain or whatever. Probably not much use, but you never know. You could also, if you wanted to have a pendant type, you could also use our 10mm cord grip component and screw that to it and create a pendant type lamp holder. Again, fairly handy, but maybe mostly used, I think, with fixed type fixtures rather than pendant type. So what I thought I'd do is go through the basics of how we wire these up. Now, because they're brass cased, they do need to be wired to a three-core cable, so it does need an earth, and in fact that's probably a good thing. The only other one we have that has an earth is this metal plate one, which has an earth, but these will all be earthed. So the first thing we need to do is turn on the small camera so you can
get this recording.
Yeah. So the first thing we've got to do is I've got to put on my glasses. So to wire these up, we obviously dismantle them, which is not easy with dirty hands. So just take that apart. We leave in the Bakelite threaded part. Now this is just to take the thread of the light globe, really. And that fits in, locks in. We have also a small clip which has got its screw busted out of it. So I will need another one with a screw in it. Just bear with me, leave it on. Okay, so the first thing we've got to do is, the third thing, I don't know what it is now, I've lost track. We'll just unscrew all of these little connectors, and you can see in there, I don't know how close you can get there. Just unscrew those. So that's just a little flathead screw. Now, what we'll do is we'll get a little bit of cable, we'll feed it through. Hang on, I'll put this in. Look, I might do this too, because there is a little screw in here. You can see that there's a little screw in there which locks the all thread so that it can't come undone. So that's a safety feature to stop it rotating when you take the globe out. So we poke the cable through, we'll spread them out a little bit. Now you could use any double insulated cable in these, but we've just got a little bit of braided cable for the heck of it. Neutral or negative, we wire into the terminal that corresponds with the outside of the thread of the globe. Does that make sense? You have to go closer. Active. We'll go into the terminal that is a centre pin of the globe. So active to the centre pin. There it is. Screw that up. And the earth or ground. and this terminal lines up with the the little tab that touches the case here. This is that little bendy tab, and that comes into contact with the case. So we screw that tight. And I would imagine this has an anti-rotation system, and it does. There's a little slot here and a little tab in there, you can see. Essentially, you should be able to put that in and that shouldn't spin. So that's the anti-rotation that stops the whole thing from coming undone and just getting stuck and rotating. Once that's in, we take the body of the lamp holder, screw that on. I'm not having a lot of luck. Oh, hang on, I've put that in there. Didn't even see that. Oh, I've actually not done one of these before, so this is a good test. It's a bit hard to hang on to. Hang on, there we go. There is an anti-rotation in there. You can feel it and you can hear it creaking and cracking, groaning. They're a little bit difficult to do up because they're hard to hold. And a very long thread, I've got to say. That's it done up. And now you can't undo that. And there will be somewhere in there a little anti-rotation device. If you do want to take it undone again, you'll need to push that in and undo it. But essentially that's it. That won't come undone. Perfect. The globe should go in now and sit on the tabs and line up properly. There you go. So that's it. Our E14 wiring for the new brass lamp holders. They're quite cute. What we will do is we'll probably build a few components with these lamp holders, and we'll show you those. Probably we'll put them on the website, but I think we'll be at work trying to make new light fittings from these over the next month or two. So there we have it. If you've got any questions about E14 lamp holder, if you've got any questions about wiring, if you've got any questions about the various components you might need to put them together in the fashion that you want to use them, certainly let us know. If you like our video, subscribe, thumbs up, all those things. Hey, say g'day to Axel, apparently. But thanks for watching. We'll get back to another video very soon. And until then, bye for now.